The conversation continues here at KLRN. I'm Jim Forsythe, joined by Sanford Nowlin, editor-in-chief of the San Antonio Courant, and Bruce Selcraig, transportation reporter from the San Antonio Express News. Thank you for joining us today. Sanford, we were talking during the TV segment about your reporting on Mayor Nirenberg's chief of staff, who is a former Valero lobbyist named Jim Greenwood. The mayor just was reelected with the strong support of the Texas Organizing Project and other liberal activist groups who like his stand against climate change. I assume that this hire is probably not going over well among those groups.
Yeah, I think it's been difficult to sort of tease out a number of folks who were involved in the debate on climate, on the climate plan, that will say, we don't like Jim Greenwood, we don't trust Jim Greenwood. But if you read between the lines, I think there's some consternation. There's a little bit of concern about what it means to have a former oil industry exec as the chief of staff. I think there's the argument to be made that by having a former Valero guy on board with the mayor, that could bring Valero along to support the climate plan, which they have been unwilling to do thus far. But at the same time, folks on the progressive front say they're worried about Greenwood. You know, given his political background, he's voted overwhelmingly in Republican mm-hmm. primaries. He's financially supported a lobbying group that has denied or at least tried to cast doubt on climate change research. And also, you know, he's somebody who's supported financially through campaign contributions a number of staunch conservative candidates like Rudy Giuliani and John Cornyn.
We had Kevin Wolff on the TV segment, and he talked about an official from Valero calling the county judge, his father, Nelson Wolff, asking, quite frankly, do you want us to leave? It seems like there is some very strong opposition among, as you might expect, among the oil and gas industry. Can this help maybe ameliorate some of the concerns that they have?
I think that's very possible. I think one of the things that's concerning to some folks on the environmental side who have watched this process is they have been very willing to get involved in the talks about what a climate plan should look like. But they point out that, you know, the oil industry executives, CPS, all these other stakeholders were invited to participate as well. And in some cases, they sent representatives mm-hmm. to these meetings. But it's not like they were there sort of at the table talking about what they would like to see in terms of a climate plan. And I also wonder, too, if Valero is threatening to relocate, what major city are they going to go to that's not right now thinking about how to deal with climate mm-hmm. change?
Bruce, you've done some very compelling reporting on the effect of the massive influx of scooters into this community and the disabled population. We talked about the problems they're having getting onto the sidewalk, getting to where they need to go. Talk about what some of the disabled individuals are telling you about what they would like the city to do to make their lives easier.
Well, the city has done the right thing, but maybe belatedly. They've banned scooters on sidewalks. That's a great first step. It should have been done from the very beginning. Cities are now catching on to that. Everyone's sort of falling in line. But now that moves scooters onto streets. And I guarantee you in San Antonio, a place that's not friendly to bikers yet and doesn't have protected bike paths like we should, that will just hasten the day that we have our first fatality. And the city needs to prepare for that. Public leaders need to prepare for that. Because you don't see it coming. It just happens for no particular reason. Today's the day it happens. And everyone should get their prepared remarks because it's going to happen. And they're going to say, we reach out to the family and we're so sorry and we're going to keep doing what we're doing. And what they need is a massive program for bike paths if that's what they want to do.
So is there a possibility maybe that the scooters might jumpstart that? That's been something that the city's been dragging its feet on for some time.
I've asked some directly, and they sort of hem and haw and go, do you mean like a massive contribution of money? No, I'm not sure we're on board with that.
Yeah.
That's one of the things we need to keep in mind when we're talking about scooters. Mm-hmm. Bird and Lime have been valued at $2 billion apiece. We're not talking about friendly little you know, Hasbro toys here. We're talking about aloof Silicon Valley startups who anybody who gets in the way of making money is not exactly a friend.
Bruce Selcraig, a transportation reporter for the Express News, Sanford Nowlin, editor-in-chief of The Current. Thank you for joining us on The Conversation Continues.